Hey, Keith Goodrich, turning product owner here at Mastercam. I've been with the company for about 8 years, and I've been a user of Mastercam for about 17. 2024, we've got three major enhancements for B-axis contour turning. First off is the adjust stock that you're used to seeing from our other toolpaths. We brought that functionality into the B-axis toolpath, but we removed the little dialogue so it's much more user-friendly. All the controls are right there on the screen. There's a nice prompt that tells you what you can and can't do with it. It's a really nice addition to control how you get into and out of the stock with the toolpath. The second one that we've got is depth of cut, but we've enhanced it with a manual option. It'll put a tool boundary up on your screen with two little balls, a red one and a green one. You can grab the balls on the insert boundary and drag it around to specify only the portion of the insert that you want to contact the contour. The third major enhancement is vector editing. You select the toolpath, you select your chain, pick a tool, and green check. You've got an automatic toolpath. It's safe motion, it's gonna get the contour cut. You can then go back in and you can click the modified option on the basic motion control tab. It'll pop up some vectors on the screen that show you where the angle's changing for the toolpath. You can double click anywhere else on the contour to add more vectors. You can delete some vectors. And when you want to make an adjustment, you click on the vector, the tool's going to appear, and our rotational gnomon is there, and you can make the rotations that you need. We've also got some collision prevention in there. The tool will light up red if you get too close or collide with another boundary, along with that secondary boundary that you're colliding with. It absolutely gives you the most fine-tuning that you can imagine with the toolpath. B-axis allows only the insert boundary to contact the chain contour. You can add portions of your insert to the holder boundary so that it will not come in contact with the chain contour anymore. It really gives you the ability to get in and fine-tune that toolpath and have it be exactly what you want it to be. For 2024, the other major enhancement for mill turn is the addition of angled milling locators for turret axis combinations. If you had a B-axis on your mill turn machine, it didn't matter what angle the feature's at, you rotate the B-axis and you go ahead and drill that hole or cut that slot. If you had a turret machine, as long as you've got the angled milling locator, you see it in backplot, you see it in verify, you see it properly simulated, and the posted code is coming out right for your machine. We also incorporated the ability to increase or decrease the spindle speed, which is super common with these components. You can also reverse the spindle speed. You program the operation to what speed and direction you want your tool to rotate to and at, and the post will make the modifications to the code so that by the time the code makes it to the machine, the tool's running how you expected it to run.